He's noticed that The Lion King is on at a local theatre. It's worth a punt.
About 6 o'clock, yeah?
Okay, thanks a lot, miss.
Thank you.
Thank you. Oh, well, we've got some work. Sold out till December. It's a fucking shame, isn't it? Come halfway around the world to work Poxy Lion King. All right, Brian. You been working at Lion King? You know it's done out, don't you, every night till December? You fancy having a mooch round here? Have you got any spare tickets you want to sell, madam? I'll buy any spare tickets. Anyone got tickets they wish to sell? What it is, our colleague's got them, but he's just finishing off his dinner in Chinatown. It'll be about 7:30. You waiting in the queue?
Yeah,
we're lovely. Yeah. Don't worry. When he comes here, I'll give him the all right. There won't be much more on the face value, do. Hello, driver. You got any extra tickets you want to sell?
How much would you give for tickets to the England-France match?
They ain't worth nothing, mate. Would you think we'd be round here if they was worth anything? This is worth more than the semi-final.
Sleep all right last night?
Yeah, brand new.
Yeah?
Yep, absolutely fine.
Any faxes?
No.
Any calls?
No. It's dead. The World Cup is dead.
The World Cup market is so slack, Slim takes the day off. He's a keen bird watcher, but when he spots England player Lawrence Dallaglio, he's in like a flash.
Any extra tickets you want to sell, sir?
Huh?
Any extra tickets you want to sell, sir?
Yeah, you got that one, did you?
5 days in Australia, he's already feeling homesick.
What do you miss when you're away?
English beer. I don't know, I miss the weather sometimes. A lot of people say, you know, how can you say that? It's lovely out here, but there's nothing quite like our seasons, is there?
It's the day of the first semi-final, but Slim's still working the Lion King.
Who's got extra tickets? Anyone got any spare tickets? Spare tickets. That's $40, all right? At least you can spend the money, can't you?
They're
I know, yeah, but it's only one on his own, isn't it?
Yeah, well, that's
everybody
right.
Wants to sit together, see?
All right, no, well, I better keep the thing.
What are you going to do with it?
Get the ticket.
Sir, excuse me, talk to me. Do you want to sell your ticket?
No, only for the price you paid for it, that's all.
Have you won the lottery, sir?
No, we haven't won the lottery.
But you're, Sue, as soon as you go inside a theatre, it's not worth anything. What did you want for it? Here, sir, come here. Take a little bit less. Take something less. See what I'll do with you. Here. Here. It's $80.
Sorry.
Are you arrogant or something? Fucking fit coach driver. Who's got spare tickets they wish to sell?
They're very unintelligent, aren't they? Seeing as they've all been descended from the filth that we got rid of.
Australian punters aren't used to touts. One's so angry he calls security up to deal with Slim.
I'm not harassing them, just it's up to them, isn't it? You know.
Yeah, just ask them quietly too.
Yeah.
I don't want me to remove you or anything. Yeah, I can't do that.
Oh no,
you know,
I understand. Yeah, yeah. No, but you can see me. I'm not going to be rude to people. I'll call people sir and madam.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah,
all right then, boss.
Thanks, mate.
I'll see you tomorrow then. I'll buy any spare tickets. Who's got tickets they wish to sell? Who's got spare tickets they wish to?
This is the first semi-final, the one we've been waiting for, the biggest rivalry in international rugby these days, Australia and New Zealand. What a night, what a prospect in store.
Wavers at the station. What I mean by wavers, they're people like genuine fans with spare tickets that are just holding them up hoping to get the face value for them. Because they are quite an expensive ticket. But you approach them and try and buy them for less than face value and they won't take it. No point in going to work.
He blows his whistle and the Wallaby New Zealand out of this game.
The first semi between Australia and New Zealand was a touting disaster, but now it's England-France, the big one.
My plan for the day, I'm just going to hopefully get some tickets laid on me. What I mean by that is so that, you know, I don't have to pay for them, I can return someone. And see what happens. Just try as hard as we can to sell them. I missed that one down to you.
What?
I don't know, I can't positively identify that one. I think it was a great egret. But see, this little pamphlet here don't give you like the locations of the birds. It's a good little guide though, you know. Or to carry around, you know, you don't want to be carrying around your binoculars and a big book when you're selling tickets.
Slim's off to a bar to meet Mr. Big, a British super tout who's bought wholesale from tour operators from the smaller competing countries. It's sail or return.
Have a mooch down here, but there's a few supporters and see what happens. Hopefully we do these and get back and get some more. Plus plumage, Billy, plus plumage. Anyone need tickets for the game? Need to get some fucking fags, that's what I need. See what I'll do, you can give us $200 a piece. You're still cheaper than the face value, isn't it? $200 is about 85 quid.
No, we do 350 if you want to do that, that's fair.
Yep, go on.
Yeah.
There you go, mate. Good luck, cheers. Thanks, mate. What's your budget for two together, the Cat B ones?
Two rows we're looking at, mate. We'd pay a fair value for the 150s.
So you want to give $150, yeah?
I'll tell Slim's you, found you want to get pitch, and things are going well
Cat B's together.
Until a rugby fan rustles in.
Mate, what are you doing to me? If someone's talking to someone else, I would never go in and say, oh, I've got a ticket to sell, you know what I mean?
I love it, 280.
Give us your 280, go on, give us your 280. See how low he goes, come on.
280, whoever's doing 280.
Yeah, give you 280, come on. Come on, give us your 280. Shut the fuck up. How many are you looking for, sir?
No, I'm not looking for anything. Just how much you've got.
Another window shopper, yeah?
Oh, no, I just want to see how much because I've been offered some.
Yeah, mate. If you're looking for a bit of laundry, third floor. Fucking stupid question.
Slim spots a bunch of Welsh supporters dressed up in berets to support the French.
I hate the Welsh. Hate them with a vengeance. They've never wanted to be a part of the union. Celts, aren't they, at the end of the day, aren't they? Not English, not Scottish. Celts. We've done something, and we've still got, 2.5 hours to go, so we'll have a mooch down the ground and see what we can do there. Get out of here.
Second semi-final from Telstra Stadium between England and France, and it's another sellout for this eagerly awaited clash.
$200 each, mate. And category B.
But this isn't the bonanza the touts expected. There are too many spare tickets going for less than face value, and most supporters have bought before flying out.
What's your budget? Cheap. Anyone need tickets?
Once the match starts, ticket prices plummet even further.
Do you want a cheap one or a good one? A cheap one. Yeah, it's $1,000. No, I'm only messing about, it's $100.
$75.
$80 here.